What does AWGN means? So AWGN plays a very crucial factor to decide the performance of a communication system. So you might be aware of the term AWGN, but in this video we will try to understand that what AWGN exactly means. Let's break down the name AWGN, because AWGN is an abbreviation for additive white Gaussian noise. Okay, and let's understand what each word means here. So if we have to decide performance of a digital communication system with an indicator like bit error rate, so in that case thermal noise plays a crucial role. And in context of wireless communication, main source of thermal noise is composition of random undesired signals born from vibration of atoms in receiver electronic circuits. Okay, so like we have transmitter receiver, and we usually model our noise at the receiver side. So basically everything or all the random undesired signals from all the electronic circuitries, even which are in vicinity of your desired circuit, constitutes noise or thermal noise in this case. Okay, additive. So while modeling the impact of noise to the transmitted signal, noise is added to the transmitted signal. For example, like this. So here Y is the received signal, X is the signal that we transmitted, and N is noise. Okay, so by what do we mean by it is additive? Like, we are not modeling it like this. We are not multiplying the noise to the transmitted signal. We are not doing this. We are actually adding the noise to the transmitted signal. Okay, so if I have to model it like this, so this will be X, this will be noise, and this will be the Y, which is received signal here. Okay, yeah, W for white. So what does it mean? That it has uniform power across whole frequency band. That means that if I have to draw the power spectral density, so power spectral density is power per unit of frequency, that will be a flat line. Okay, and in theory or literature, you might have noticed that this power spectral density is N0 by 2. We will talk about this more, but this is a flat line. So its power spectral density is flat, and this analogy has been taken from colors. Like, white color is composed of all frequency components in visible spectrum. Similarly, this AWGN noise contains all frequency components and its power is also flat. That's why the name white is given. Okay, and this power spectral density is equals to K times T, where K is a constant and T is the temperature in Kelvin, and this is as per the Nyquist's research. So noise power is directly proportional to the equivalent temperature at the receiver front end. That's why the name thermal noise is given to this. And historically, this constant value is denoted as N0 by 2 watts per hertz, as we have already mentioned. So if we take the IDFT, which is inverse discrete Fourier transform of power spectral density, which is the autocorrelation function of the signal. So they have the relation that PSD is Fourier transform of autocorrelation function. So this constant spectral density means that autocorrelation of the noise in the time domain is a unit impulse. You might be aware of this relation that the Fourier transform of unit impulse is a flat line in frequency domain. Okay, so it will be like this. If I draw it in time domain, so it will be a unit impulse. This will be the autocorrelation. What does it mean? What does it imply? So it implies that each noise sample in a sequence is uncorrelated, with every other noise sample in the same sequence. Okay, therefore mean value of white noise is zero. So because their mean values are zero and they are uncorrelated, so that also means that every noise sample is independent of each other. They are not dependent, like noise sample at particular time is not dependent on noise sample on another time. They have the independent nature. Okay, now let's take a question that if we have to calculate noise power for a particular bandwidth, how can we calculate that? So given we know the power spectral density, that the power spectral density is N0/2 watts per hertz, and this is across frequency, and let's say bandwidth is B. So bandwidth is like this, this is B. Okay, so this is watts per hertz. So if we have to calculate the noise power, which I am denoting here as Pn, so simply just multiply the power spectral density by the bandwidth, and this will be the power in this particular bandwidth. Very simple to calculate. Okay, now G for Gaussian. So as these are random variables, therefore we have to define their statistical parameters like probability density function, or commonly known as PDF. Okay, because these are statistical parameters. These are random variables, so this is one of the statistical parameter. And the probability density function PDF of noise, or specifically AWGN, is Gaussian in nature. Gaussian in nature with zero mean. And this is how its PDF looks like. You might have seen this. We also say this a bell curve or bell shaped curve. Okay, so what it means that values near to zero or mean, values near to zero or mean have higher probability of occurrence because they are because across the mean, which is this, the PDF function is higher. So it also means that probability of occurrence for the samples which are near to mean or near to zero in this case is higher than the samples which are far from them, like these samples, like the samples here. Okay, now you may have one question that why Gaussian, why the PDF or probability density function of noise is Gaussian. So we can explain this with the help of central limit theorem. So what central limit theorem says, that it says that the sum of independent and identically distributed, or we say it IID, random variables approaches normal distribution as sample size n tends to infinity. Okay, another way of looking into this, that if we are summing two random variables, so let's say if I am summing two random variables which are x and y, then the PDF, let's say this is z, so I say x is Gaussian and y is also Gaussian. So the PDF of z, let's denote it as this, is the convolution of PDF of x and y. Okay, and central limit theorem is telling me that this noise contains infinite number of, or many number of samples. So let's say if I am denoting the random variable of noise as n, then the noise contains a lot of number of random variables. Here is n is tending to infinity. Okay, so read it again, that sum of independent and identically distributed random variable approaches normal distribution as size n tends to infinity. Let's we will also look into this, that how it is reaching to normal distribution. But because we know that noise is what, it is composition of many number of random signals, which we can denote it by this equation. So let's start with n is equals to 2. So let's see how the PDF tends to Gaussian in that case. So I'll take a very simple example. Like, let's take instead of Gaussian, let's take x and y as a uniform random variable. So their PDF will be rectangular. Okay, this will be the PDF of x, and this will be the PDF of y. Okay, and let's assume that for my noise, only these two random variables are summing. So if I have to calculate the PDF of a variable z or noise, it will be the convolution of these two rectangular pulses. And we know that if we convolve two rectangular pulses, it comes as a triangular function. So this will be the PDF of z. Okay, but actually noise is a superposition of many number of symbols. So if I take or if I extend this convolution for n tends to infinity, there will be multiple such convolutions, and the actual PDF shape will tends to be normal or Gaussian. Okay, this will be the PDF of noise. Okay, maybe I think you got the point that let's start from only superposition or composition of two random variables which have uniform probability density function. The output will be a triangular, and if we go on to convolve to triangular, it will be something close to normal. But if we convolve n number of such random variables where n is tending to infinity or n is a very high number, the output or the probability density function of the composite signal, which is noise in this case, or AWGN in this case, will tends to a Gaussian probability density function. Please put a thumbs up to this video if you find it useful. Please subscribe to the channel and do share your questions or feedback in the comments.